Hey guys, just 2 months ago on September 17, something very strange happened in the ancient Chennakesava temple at Belur. In late afternoon, about 5:30 p.m., a small stone ball fell down from the top of this pillar. Only a very few people noticed this, and most people do not even know such an event happened. What could be so special about that particular day and time? Why would a ball magically drop from this ancient pillar? In a few minutes, it became clear that an earthquake had hit the entire area. It was a mild earthquake with a 2.3 magnitude on a Richter scale, but pillars don't magically release balls. In fact, pillars should actually fall down during an earthquake. And this pillar probably did not fall down because it's firmly buried inside this large base, right? But when we take a closer look, we are completely shocked by this. This pillar is not buried in the base at all. It's not even attached to the base. It's just made to stand there with no support at the bottom or at the top. This is a completely freestanding pillar. They have simply placed it with no support, no binding material, no foundation, and not even a little bit of mortar or cement to attach it to the floor. This is impossible. Imagine making a long cylinder like a pencil stand on a table. It's very hard, but now turn on the fan and make the wind blow on it to mimic the wind blowing in the temple, and then shake the table to mimic the earthquake. Will the pencil still be standing? Even worse, this pillar is not standing on all four corners. It's just standing on three legs. One of the corners is not even resting on the floor. Authorities say you can pass a thin cloth or paper through the space and prove that it's not resting. And they used to do it before, but now people are forbidden from going near the pillar. But let me zoom in, and you can clearly see that one of the corners is just hanging in the air. And this pillar is huge. Archaeologists say this is monolithic, a single giant block of granite standing 42 feet tall, about 3.5 feet wide, and must weigh about 45 tons. Archaeologists confirm that this is not a recent structure. It is, in fact, ancient. How was it erected? How was it made to just balance like this with no support? And most importantly, how was it still standing after so many centuries? To make it balance like this, the builders must have had an insane ability to precisely calculate the center of gravity. There is no way they can create such a miracle without a scientific understanding of the center of gravity. But is there any evidence in this temple itself to prove that ancient builders understood gravity? There is something very strange and secretive about this temple. In 1926, not only did Indian leaders like Gandhi and Nehru visited this temple, but Pakistan's first Prime Minister, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, also visited this temple. Why would a Muslim who does not believe in idol worship visit this temple? He did not come to worship, but he was interested in watching a strange scientific phenomenon associated with this carving. This particular idol, called Mohini, was removed from the top and brought down for a strange demonstration to these leaders. You can immediately see that her posture is different. She seems to be standing like a puppet connected to an invisible string. Her both hands hit this. But there is no string. In fact, she is letting a drop of water drip from a finger on her top hand. An actual drop of water was used in front of the leaders while keeping the statue erect. The drop fell from the finger of her right hand, exactly between her brows, touched the nose, touched her left nipple, fell exactly between her legs, and touched the extended toe on her left leg before falling on the ground. It's said that all the three politicians instantly stood up and gave a standing ovation when they saw this demonstration. How could an ancient builder carve such an idol without understanding gravity? It's clear that he understood how any object falling from above must reach the ground, but he must have also understood the center of gravity to design the idol in such a wonderful fashion. Remember, I told you this figure is called Mohini. What is the meaning of Mohini in Sanskrit? An irresistible pull, an invisible attraction. Superficially, it appears to have a sexual connotation, which is also indicated in the carving. But is it really a woman we are talking about? Or are we talking about that invisible force of attraction, aka gravity? This entire temple indicates so many features of Mohini, that invisible force of attraction. Look at this Mohini. You can be easily distracted by her beauty. But look at that last bangle, how it's slipping below her wrist because of gravity. Maybe just a coincidence? Now, look at her leg. Again, her anklet too is ready to fall down because of gravity. I can go on and on about how gravity is shown in so many carvings in this temple. If you start looking, you can find that invisible pull or gravity depicted everywhere. The more you start looking, the more you realize that the entire temple is full of depictions about gravity. But the largest Mohini is found inside the main chamber of this temple. The priests here follow a very strange tradition because this 12 feet tall statue is dressed up as Mohini every day, and she does emit an irresistible pull. Even more strange, it's said that there are carvings inside this chamber which explain gravity, but no one is allowed to enter or photograph inside the main chamber. Too bad we cannot examine this Mohini, but in the ancient temple of Kudumianmalai, there are two very strange giant carvings of Mohini. These carvings are called Gurutva Mohinis. The story is quite interesting. Once upon a time, there was a great guru. He was a great saint. Younger disciples were so attracted to him because of his principles. But to destroy his saintliness, this beautiful giant Mohini appears. And you know Mohini has an irresistible attraction. And sure enough, the guru loses his spiritual state of mind. And look at his smile. It's almost like he has completely lost his mind. Look at his arms here. He is completely surrendered to Mohini. And you can see Mohini, this giant source of attraction, completely pulling everyone, each and every disciple of the guru. Of course, you may wonder why such explicit carvings are put right in the middle of a temple. This is not even in a hidden part of the temple. These two carvings are placed where everyone could see them. But the question is, are we really talking about humans? Or are we talking about how larger bodies attract smaller bodies? The smaller disciples were attracted to the larger guru. But when a giant body appears, the larger saint is also attracted to the even larger body. This is the basis of gravity, right? This is why a smaller object like the moon revolves around the Earth, while a larger object like the Earth revolves around a much larger object like the sun. But the name Gurutva Mohini is very strange. We know Mohini means pull, but what does Gurutva mean? It means gravity. I know this sounds very strange because many of you may think the word gravity was created by Newton recently. But no, the word Gurutva in Sanskrit and the word gravitas in Latin have existed for more than 2,000 years, denoting gravity. Newton may have been the first one to give the exact mathematical formula, but gravity was understood very well in ancient India. In fact, in 628 AD, an Indian mathematician and astronomer by the name of Brahmagupta mentions the exact word gravitational pull in Sanskrit, describing how objects attract one another. He clearly used the term Gurutva for gravity. So the word Gurutva Mohini definitely means gravitational pull, but in another ancient temple, this is confirmed beyond a shred of doubt. In this temple, there is a very old wooden carving which is ready to disintegrate soon. The carving shows two smaller saints attracted to the larger Mohini in the center. Their attraction to Gurutva Mohini is shown in a very subtle way. Their phalluses are both attracted to the Gurutva Mohini in the center, just like how all planets move around the sun because of gravitational pull. Normally, I don't show erotica, but this is so intertwined with science that I do have to show you this. The details are just insane. There is an incredible mix of science, sex, and spirituality. And Gurutva Mohini, is she actually human? Or is she just a symbol, a symbolic representation of gravity? There is one aspect that might stun you. There is no navel or belly button in this wooden carving of Mohini. This is probably a clue that Gurutva Mohini is not human. It probably just means gravitational pull. I don't fully understand the symbols because in some Mohinis, you can see the navel, and in some Mohinis, it's deliberately not carved. For example, in this Mohini carved in Chennakesava temple, again, there is no navel, probably to indicate that she's actually not human, but just gravitational pull. At this point, it should be obvious that the builders of this temple definitely understood gravity and the center of gravity very well. But now the question is, why did ancient builders erect this giant pillar without any support in this temple? Just to show us that they can do it? What was the actual purpose of this pillar? Some claim that this is a lamppost, meaning that ancient people were actually placing oil lamps on top of this pillar to light up the place after dark. This is a very absurd theory. If it's so easy to climb this pillar every day to put oil lamps on top, why put a huge signboard now saying don't touch it? Another obvious feature that you may have noticed is that there are no steps or holes to let anyone climb on it. Another strange theory that some experts hold is that they had a huge wooden stairs that goes all the way to the top right next to this pillar. If they used a giant wooden staircase, why do they need to create the pillar, right? Just light the lamp on top of the staircase. But then they say the staircase is temporary and the stone is permanent. But it's quite useless without the staircase. So why didn't they put a permanent stone staircase? Why do they have to build an extraordinary stone pillar and make it balance on three corners just for the sake of a lamppost. These are just old myths, and it's obvious that this pillar has never been scientifically scrutinized. For example, archaeologists claim that this is a monolithic pillar. But when you zoom in at the top, there are two extra stone blocks fit on the top. On the very top, you can see a square block, and below that, an octagonal stone block is also screwed on the pillar like a bolt nut. The difference in their color and the gaps clearly reveal that these are different stone blocks. Why are they placed there at the very top? Is it possible that this stone block will rotate when an earthquake happens? Look carefully, it appears that this will, in fact, rotate. I've already shown you the rotating part of another ancient temple in Bangalore, which is just 130 miles away from this temple. The design of this pillar and the rotating top look quite similar. And you can see some old metal clamps and rusted metal bells at the top as well. I think it's obvious that if the bells were new, the bells will ring when the earthquake happens, right? Is this a clue to understand the actual purpose of the pillar? Was this pillar designed specifically to indicate and measure earthquakes? Is this why it's not fixed firmly to the ground, but balanced like this? Most people think the seismograph, the device to measure earthquakes, was invented recently, but the oldest known seismograph was used 1,900 years ago in China. And all seismographs have parts that are not firmly fixed to the ground. They must have parts that are not attached to the ground, which can shake to measure the intensity of the earthquake. Even more interesting, every time there was an earthquake, the ancient Chinese seismograph would release a metal ball into the mouth of one of these frogs. This is very similar to what happened at the Chennakesava temple. Was this pillar built as a seismograph in ancient times? And is it still working by releasing stone balls to indicate earthquakes? Why else would it be designed with such painstaking precision with rotating parts? Why else was it made to stand without any support? Why does the temple itself depict so many details about gravity and balancing? I hope you like this video. I am Praveen Moha. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.